And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity. My friends on the panel would recognize our guest immediately, so they have, as usual, been provided with blindfolds. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Good. Will you come in, Mystery Challenger, and sign in, please? In the case of our mystery challenger, we dispense with all usual preliminaries and get right down to the general questioning. I would tell you that our guest's voice is, I think, so well known that I'm going to answer the first few questions, perhaps the first round's questions. But let's get right down to cases and begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Are you accustomed to facing crowds?
Yes.
What a clue.
That's you, John.
That's me. You mean it was not recognizable, Bennett?
Yes, it was adorable.
Well, are we to gather that this person's voice is even more famous than that of, say, a famous motion picture star?
Yes. Well, you know, all things are relative in this relative world of ours. I would say that our guest's voice is most famous, and we would leave the comparative to the decision of that individual who chose to pose the question.
Thank you, John. That cleared everything up nicely. Is this person, would I be likely to recognize this person's voice if it was heard on the radio?
Would you be likely to recognize this person's voice if it was heard on the radio? I would think you might, yes.
Is our guest a public figure rather than an actor or actress?
A public figure rather than an actor or actress? Yes, I would think so.
Does our guest appear regularly on television?
Does our guest, by which you mean on a regular weekly program?
No, but quite frequently.
Well, I would think that quite frequently would not be exactly correct. Would you? No,
good,
I would have to give you
a
no there. I'm sorry, Dorothy. I think you hung yourself up. We'll have to let that one down and nine to go, Mr. Allen.
He appears on television, but not too frequently, is that it?
That's about it.
Well, we're both in the same boat then, so it's... Is he in the, does he operate in the political arena in any
does
way?
Does he operate in the political arena?
Uh-huh.
I would say that you get a no there because it's not a he. That makes it two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Oh, are you intimating then that it is a lady that sometimes operates in a political arena?
I'm not meaning to intimate anything. If you would like to ask that specific question, we'd be glad to entertain it.
Have you now or have you ever been associated with politics?
Have you now?
Are you now or have you ever been associated with politics?
I would think that the answer to that would have to be yes.
Thank you.
Since you used associated.
Oh.
But that is also to advise you that in one way or another, almost every good citizen of this country is associated with politics.
We will now say I pledge allegiance in uniform. are you in Washington?
Right
now? Of course, you understand. But is your main job one that keeps you in Washington most of the time?
Is your main job one that keeps you in Washington most of the time? I would say no to that, with our guest's permission. That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Cerf.
Well, would our distinguished guest be found in the vicinity ever of the United Nations set up?
In the vicinity of the United Nations? Well, I would think probably we might find our guest in the vicinity of the United Nations, yes.
Now, knowing your very tricky and sly ways, John, you talked about a citizen of this country. I don't think that this may necessarily be a citizen of this country.
We would be...
Is this lady a citizen? Is it true that this lady is not a citizen of the United States?
Is it true that this lady is not a citizen of the United States. That would make it 4 down and 6 to go. I got it figured out. All right, Miss Kilgallen.
I dislike asking a lady about a birthday, but has our guest recently had a birthday that was celebrated by a great many friends?
Well, I'm now going to ask our guest if she will to answer the question herself. Have you recently had a birthday that was celebrated?
Fairly.
Is our guest ever found in the vicinity of Hyde Park, New York?
Is our guest ever found in the vicinity of Hyde Park, New York?
And almost every other vicinity you can think of.
Not often.
No?
I think once in a while, Miss Dorothy.
Oh, you mean I'm still on?
Yes, you're still on.
Is our guest famous for traveling?
Is our guest famous for traveling?
Yes.
Is she also a newspaper columnist?
Yes.
Did she ever occupy the White House?
Yes.
Is it Mrs. Franklin Delano Roosevelt?
Mrs. Franklin Delano Roosevelt. And I must say that perhaps particularly tonight, Bennett, you touched on a very tender and fond spot when you mentioned the United Nations.
I thought you were being Madame Panda.
Well, tonight, I think everybody knows, begins the 8th annual observance of United Nations Week. It needs no one, least of all me, to tell the great part that our guest has played in the development of the United Nations. And we're very pleased and proud, Mrs. Roosevelt, to have you as our guest. I think perhaps, too, that you could describe better than anyone just what the purpose of United Nations Week is.
Well, United Nations Week, of course, is, I think, rather an American undertaking. The American Association for the United Nations started United Nations Week as preparation for United Nations Day, which is an international day. Practically as many countries as are members try to commemorate United Nations Day. But we in this country try to prepare during the week beforehand so as to spread more information and understanding about what the day really means.
And that is the week that we're beginning tonight.
That is the week we're beginning tonight.
Well, I think to get that week off to a good start, you're the best spokesman that anyone could possibly hope to have. And
hear, hear.
More than that, this is a banner day for What's My Line. We will always remember very fondly that you honored us by being our mystery guest, and I'm sure that the panel would love very much to shake your hand and say good night. Thank you, Mrs. Roosevelt.